was and what I was going to say is that in the discussions on the next phase of Koronivia, we need a large mandate and a very strong and comprehensive mandate that really deals with the entire food system. Because so far, the discussions have been mostly focusing on the sort of production side of things. And it's really important that parties agree on that strong and that clear mandate to cover all elements of food systems, including obviously food loss and food waste. And that approach is going to allow us to have a very strong, comprehensive grasp of the issue. So really, I'm looking forward to the discussions happening on Koronivia here in China Chair, and also looking forward actually to the intervention that's going to come next on food loss and food waste and what happens quickly on the ground to reduce food loss and food waste. Because I feel that governments really need to have that wider approach that really includes food loss and waste to make sure that we have a really comprehensive approach to the topic of food systems in the OCCC, and that the next phase of Koronivia can really deliver, obviously, for climate, for nature, and for people. Thank you.
Thank you, Primo, and I'm happy that we solved the technical problems. Because of this, we have quickly to reorganize the agenda today, because some of the speakers have agreed to leave right in time. And I wanted first now to introduce to you Desmond Aluguna. He just made it, and he has to leave
climate change and adaptation action on climate change and adaptation action. Again, that food is there. As Moore and Katrina said, food system are a whole of how we produce food, how we transport them, how we distribute, process and consume them, or waste them. Which forms the food system, how it is contributing to climate change by contributing 1/3 of the global greenhouse gas emissions. Of course, this contribution varies from region to region, from country to country, from context to context, but food system and food prices and climate crisis that we are facing today, I think in many ways are the two sides of the same coin. We cannot address one without addressing the other. We cannot address climate change without addressing the food crisis, and we cannot address the food crisis without really doing something about climate change. Because we dare not get not only that food system contributes to greenhouse gas emissions, but at the same time, we see that sometimes in Australia, we see that's why 1/3 of agricultural
So I think I would end there, mine for this time. Thank you very much. And unfortunately, I won't be able to make this there for the show, but the community is just down there at home. And feel free to follow up for any questions. Thank you.
Maybe the integration of food loss and waste in the future of Koronivia. And maybe also talk a little bit about